टू कवर फ्यू टॉपिक्स ऑन द चैप्टर विजुलाइजिंग सॉलिड शेप्स, दैट इज चैप्टर 15th ऑफ योर बुक. सो द टुडे इज आवर टॉपिक इज व्यूइंग डिफरेंट सेक्शंस ऑफ अ सॉलिड. नाउ लेट अस सी हाउ एन ऑब्जेक्ट विच इज इन 3D कैन बी व्यूड इन डिफरेंट वेज. वन वे टू व्यू एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज कटिंग और स्लाइसिंग. Slicing game. Here is a loaf of bread. It is cut. It is like a cuboid with a square face. You slice it with a knife. When you give a vertical cut, you will get several pieces as shown in the figure. Each face of the piece is a square. We call this face a cross section of the whole bread. The cross section is nearly a square in this case. Now, then we have next thing. So there's a difference when we cut it horizontally, when we cut it vertically. Horizontally means like this surface we are having, so in this way we are cutting. Vertical means like this way we are cutting. A kitchen plate. Have you noticed cross sections of some vegetables when they are cut for the purpose of cooking in the kitchen? Observe the various slices and get aware of the shapes that they result as a cross section. So if you see here, play this. Make a clay or the plasticine models of the following solids and make vertical and horizontal cuts. So draw a rough sketch of the cross sections you obtain, name them wherever you can in the same way. Okay, so if you do this one thing in the practically, then you will get more knowledge of this, then you will get the more idea of from which angle, like what kind of the shape we are getting when we are cutting it horizontally, when we are cutting it vertically, or with some other angles and others. So with this we come to this topic. Then we have the exercise 15.3, that we'll cover in the same video. I'll give you the solution also. Then the other way is by shadow play. Shadows are the good ways to illustrate how three-dimensional objects can be viewed in two dimensions. Have you seen a shadow play? Like you have seen this shadow play. This normally you have seen in the reality shows also, and even you have also tried this in your home. Yes. So in a form of entertainment, using a solid articulated figures in the front of an illuminated backdrop to create the illusion of moving images, it makes some indirect use of the ideas in the mathematics. You will need some source of light and a few solid shapes for this activity. If you have an overhead projector, place the solid under the lamp and do these investigations. So keep a torchlight right in front of a cone. What shape of the shadow does it cast on the screen? If you see the figure, we are putting a cone. What we are getting here, we can see a triangle we are getting in this way. So different things we can try. If instead of cone you place a cube in the above game, then if you place a cube, maybe you are getting a square shape, maybe you are getting a rectangle shape. Yes, if you are putting the cuboid. So experiment different positions with the source of a light and with the different positions of the solid objects, study the effects on the shapes and the size of the shadow you get. If we see, like whenever we are playing the game, whenever we are playing the game in the open, then we can just see the images of the shadow that is formed by the sun of ourselves. Yes, like in the morning it's something different, in the noon time it is something different, in the afternoon time something different, in the evening time something different. So for example, say is another funny experiment that you might have tried already. Place a circular plate in the open when the sun is at the noon time, it is just above it as shown. Yes, just above it as shown. In the same way, if you see the four noons, you can see the length of the shadow. Okay, you can change the direction of the shadow in the such way. Means all these things are there. So after this, we have the 15.4 exercise based on this way. Okay, so this also we are just covering in the same video. Okay, so what we have in the same way, if you see that, like the third way of looking at it in the form of a certain angles to get different views, like this is a house. So this is the front view of the house. This is a slight, if you see, this is a side view of the house, this is a top view of the house, like the satellite view you can see. If you see this here, then building, this is a building. Okay, then the front view of the building is this. This is the side view, means this side, and this is the top view. Top view means this is a roof. What we look, if you suppose as we can see it as a satellite view, then you can do this figure by joining the cubes. Okay, fine. So if you see, this is a given figure. Now this is the, yes, if you see, this will be the view, which view we have to tell. Then this is the side view, like this is the top view, like this is the, okay, this is the view of the object. Then we have a side view, front view, and likewise. So in this way you can try in this exercise. Which is a front look, which is a top look, which is a side view, likewise. Okay, so what we have done, this is this is what we have done in this chapter. So in the same video you will get the solution of exercise 15.3 and 15. So hello dear students, now today we are going to discuss the exercise 15.3 and 15.4, the chapter 15, visualizing solid shapes. Looking at the very first question of the exercise 15.3, what cross sections do you get when you give a vertical cut, horizontal cut to the following solids? So looking at these, the first is we have a brick. So if we see here in the brick, so this is a bigger the brick. Now when we give a vertical cut from this, so this is the result. And then when we give the horizontal cut, means when we cut this from this side, so then we'll get this is a required result. In the same way, if we have a round apple, so the vertical, this is a vertical cut, so we'll get these two results, and this is the horizontal cut, then this will be the result. In the same way, if we see the dies, so in a die, if we cut vertically, we'll get the two pieces like this, and horizontally we'll get the two pieces like this. Then if we have circular pipe, if we cut the circular pipe vertically, this the figure we are getting, and the then in the case of the horizontal, we are getting like two vertical or circular pipes. Then if we see in the ice cream cone, so if in the ice cream cone, if we see, if we cut the ice cream cone, then this is a vertical cut and this is a horizontal cut. So in the horizontal cut, this is a cone and this is the, actually this is this such kind of figure known as frustum. So these two things, like you have seen the glass tumblers and others. So then if we see now the next exercise, exercise 15.4, so a bulb is kept burning just right above the following solids. Name the solid shade of the shadows obtained in each case. Attempt to give a rough sketch of the shadow. You may try to experiment first and then answer these questions. If you look here, so if we see a ball, then a cylindrical pipe and a book. So if a ball, if at this position, the what kind of shadow we are getting? We are getting a circular shape. We are getting the shape of the shadow as a circular shape. In the second one, if we see the cylinder pipe, we just throw the light from the vertical point, then we'll get a line, the shadow in a shape of a line. Then in a book will get a rectangle, like in the third one we have seen. Now if we see, it's question number two. Here are the shadows of some 3D objects when seen under the lamp of the overhead projectors. Identify the solids that match each shadows. There may be multiple answers. So in case of a circle, so if we see that in a case of a circle, what we'll get? So in case of a circle, we can have a chapati, we can have a football, disc or plate. So all these 3D objects will give a shape of a circle. Then a square, square can be of a die, square paper sheet or a cubical magic box or chalk box, etc. So many things we have. Triangle, ice cream cone will give us triangle, birthday cap will give us a triangle, and etc. These are 3D objects. We are not talking about the 2D objects. Then rectangle, geometry box can give us the rectangle shape, the shadow shape, then book, table, etc. Then the question number 3, examine if the following are the true statements or not. If we see here, now a cube can cast a shadow in a shape of a rectangle. Answer is true. A cube can cast a shadow in the shape of a hexagon. The answer is false. So in this way we have solved both the exercises. So thank you very much.